Hey everyone, welcome to the industry show. I'm your host Nitin Bajaj, and joining me today is Radhika Bajoria. Radhika, welcome on the show.
Thanks, Nitin. It's a pleasure to be here.
Pleasure is all ours. So let's get started with the big question. Who is Radhika?
My name is very common, although my traits are not so common. So maybe for people to get to know me, they'll have to meet me in person or maybe watch this interview just to get a tinge of who I am, because I don't think so. I have a very unique identity in this world. I'm just a speck of dust. The world and the universe is much larger. But for me, I think I'm a person who is open to having such kind of conversations. And I'm very candid when it comes to giving feedback or reacting to any feedback or taking criticisms my way. So I think that quality has made me fearless, and that fearlessness has led me to do, you know, many more things in my life that people of my age are probably not doing because they are fear, not because they are incapable. So I think right now people recognize me as somebody who writes content on LinkedIn, and with that content they are benefited, because they get to read the news in the most simplest form, maybe. So I think that's who I am right now. That's how people recognize me as of today. So yeah, I think that should give you a summary of who I am.
It does. And I think, you know, it goes much beyond. Those are some wise words coming at that age, where you figured out that we are all nothing but a speck of dust. But at the same time,
yeah,
you have identified the biggest thing that stops us from achieving our potential, that's fear, right? And once we overcome that, the world is our oyster. So tell us a little more about the representative.
So the representative is something that shaped me up into being what I am today, and it shaped up my LinkedIn as well. I never used to read newspapers ever in my life, and I was never fond of reading in general, but I had the right kind of environment in my college. I had the right support group. My peers were very encouraging and motivating. So I was a part of my entrepreneurship cell of the college. And from there on, we decided that let's do something which will bring in stories of different people on air so that they can also learn from it. So at the representative, you know, we interview different entrepreneurs, different CEOs, and various other people from different backgrounds, just get to know their story, which normal anchors usually don't ask. So that is what unique value proposition is. And what we do is just write news and other stories in the most simplest way possible, because this venture just came out of a problem, you know. As we say, necessity is the mother of invention.
Yes.
So we had this problem in our college that not many of us could understand what the newspapers are talking about. It was so complicated for most of us. So we thought that why not just take a move at it? I mean, even though we are not really good at what the news is talking about, but if we read, we can definitely develop our brain. Like, nobody is incapable, like I said, and I strongly believe in it.
Mm-hmm.
And this has taken me a lot of time. And like I said, because I had the right company around me, I could motivate myself into reading news, into developing this venture of ours, which we started back in October 2019. I and my friends came together. We took some interviews of people on the streets. We also took some interviews of CEOs in their offices, you know, to give our audience the best of both the worlds and to get to know what, you know, the perspectives are for a person who's sitting in a really air-conditioned huge room, mm-hmm. and for a person who's just sitting on the streets with nothing but just happiness. You know, I think it's been a good journey so far, and right now we have a team of writers and editors who help us in making infographics and help us in you know, writing content in the most simplest way possible. So our only motto right now is to educate young people like me and others in the college to read news and just encourage them naturally to go out there and write about anything that you will want to write on. So yeah, I think that's the platform.
Give us a sense of the size and scale and also the reach of your operations.
So it's not a full-fledged business per se. It's a passion-based project which started back in college, and still we are all working in our own professional lives. The founders are also working at Deloitte, at White Hat Junior, and I myself am working in a law firm. So we are not full-time dedicated to doing this, but it's just within us that we have to follow it as our passion, as our hobby. So we take some time out and dedicated to this platform. So our reach is not very huge as it should have, as it would have been had we dedicated our full time. But that number doesn't really matter to us. What matters to us is that even if one person is reading our newsletter or our piece, and if he or she is getting inspired to, you know, read more and more or write more and more about those domains or sectors, I think that's a success for us. And we really don't look at numbers. Because had we done that, we wouldn't have survived so long for these 2 years. It's just our inner happiness and satisfaction that we get that drives us. So I wouldn't really go into talking about numbers, because that is not what defines us at all. We just are like, you know, musicians playing in Himalaya somewhere. You know, we just do it for hobby. If somebody calls us to perform somewhere, we just go and we just do a brand collaboration if something comes our way, you know, because we are like poor people, we also need some money to survive. So we just take those things on our way, but we're just enjoying our lives anyways by doing what we love.
I think you're focusing on the right things, right? Which is, one, you're doing it for the right reasons, which is educating people, providing them the right information. And by not focusing and getting fixated on the numbers, it allows you to follow your passion and keep doing it for the right reasons. So I really appreciate that approach that all of you at the representative are taking. You know, you mentioned your audience is the young readers or people who typically wouldn't go to the newspapers because it's too, you know, just too much, right?
Yeah.
Give us a sense for the biggest challenge you face, right? I would think there is so much information out there, and you know, you're making it extremely easy for people to digest it. But from your perspective, as you do that, what is the biggest challenge?
So, you know, challenge lies in the eyes of the beholder, I suppose. You know, if you look at it as a difficult problem, it will appear to you as a difficult one. But if you think that it's just something that you would like to explore generally and casually, take it up and see how it pans out, I think that's how you enjoy the process as well. Yes. Otherwise, it's just a stressful situation. You know, whenever you prepare too much or whenever you are expecting something, things really don't work out well. And I'm sure that we all have our life circumstances on this kind of a journey, to say. But I think there's a lot of information there today. But I think if you like something, you will find niche. Don't listen to everybody saying, because that will just make you more confused. And, you know, whenever you eliminate choices, that's where you build your focus. That's where you see your path clearly. Otherwise, it becomes very foggy. And it's good in a way that at your initial stage in life, if you are exploring many areas, it just helps you develop your general smartness. It's not bad in any sense, but like I said, it's good to have a focused approach as well in your life later on. So I think what we do while selection of topics is that whatever we find it interesting to read on, we just start writing on it. We don't really care about how people will think about it, how people will interpret it, because at the end of the day, we all are human beings, and more or less our minds work in the same direction. So if something is interesting me, I'm sure it would interest you as well. And you know, writing is an art. It's up to you, how do you make it more interesting for other people to read who might not be interested in the topic. So we blend both writing skills and the research skills together to come up with the pieces that we do. So I think yeah, that's about it in a nutshell. And I wouldn't recommend anyone to read or refer to any sources per se, because, you know, whenever as humans we are told to do something, we try to do opposite of it.
Yes.
So no suggestions, recommendations or advice to anyone, up to people what they'll read or what they would want to read. Just that, build that inner inspiration in you to just get started.
I love that. Tell us about the, you know, the opposite of a challenge, or as challenges come about, so do opportunities, right? So what's the biggest opportunity according to you?
Opportunities are created every minute. You know, it's just up to you if you see it or no. Right now, we're living in an age of technology where the opportunity is just right in front of you. People go viral in just a few seconds. In a day, somebody gains millions of followers. How is all of that happening? You know, social media has changed our lives drastically and made people superstars from nothing.
Yes.
So I think everything is just right there. Your first job is right in front of you, only if you prepare and go there, only if you take step. So I think there's nothing for you to wait and, you know, wait for the right opportunity to come in. You know, it's just that you have the key and you have to build the door for yourself.
Yes.
Nobody will come and tell you that this is the door. When you open it, you'll find an opportunity for yourself. And it's not good to expect also, you know, because expectations always lead to disappointments. And who would want to live a disappointed life, you know?
Yes.
Life is so short these days. You never know. And, you know, predictability is the most disgusting thing that a man can do. That just leads to disguise and nothing else. So better to just travel on an unpredictable path in a very exciting way, and also be confident of whatever you're doing. I think that's what everybody looks at today. If you're confident of yourself, you will be confident about the subject that you're talking about, and the opportunities will just attract to you. You know, it's just like chasing money. The more you chase it, the more you don't get it. So I think just don't chase anything. There are many quotes that says, chase opportunities and it will come to you. I don't think so. They come, they just run more far away.
Yes.
Better to just keep doing whatever you're doing without expecting anything, but just be the best at it and know that you are the best. I think that should be the mantra.
And I love it. And it's about the confidence, following the path that you have set. Like you said, you know, it's not about waiting for something. It's not about expecting something. It's just creating your own path and things will start happening. So I love that attitude. Tell us about a moment that you're really proud of, whether it was related to a success or something that did not work out and became a learning lesson or a learning opportunity for you.
Yeah, so just to take a very simple example that everybody could relate with, whosoever is hearing this, when I started out to write content on LinkedIn, the initial traction wasn't so great because I'm not a star kid that people will directly start following me. I had to build my own audience and create my own niche. So in the beginning, it was disheartening for me to see that, why are people not reacting to whatever I've written? I've put in so much of time and effort into it. But then later on, I realized that they don't know that I've put in so much of time and efforts. They don't know who Radhika is.
Yes.
Why should they be even considering and letting my thought enter into their minds? So I thought that it's never about them. It's always about you. And it's not from a selfish perspective that I'm saying this, but it's from a perspective that makes you, you know, just confident into doing what you're doing. So I think that was the most disappointing moment for me at that point in time, because I was young, I was 18. Back then, I didn't realize that this is not what I should be focusing on. And it took me really good amount of time to realize this and move ahead of it. But once I moved over it, once I started consistently doing what I am doing currently also, I started seeing results. And I don't think so. This formula really works for everyone. I see many people who are consistently doing what they're doing, but they don't see success. So I wouldn't say that consistency is the key. Everybody has their own key in their life, and that's how they unlock their own experiences.
Mm-hmm.
But for me personally, consistency has been my key per se. And it just made me realize that I can also be a great content writer, and I can really write news, you know. So I just started doing that, and my most proud moment that I recently had was when LinkedIn awarded me this,
yes.
You know, top 20, LinkedIn recognized me as one of the top 20 creators in India. So I think that was very good achievement for me individually, because I never saw that coming, and that's the beauty of it. I was just traveling on an unforeseen journey, and when this miracle just happened, I was very happy to receive it, you know, because had I just expected it coming my way, it wouldn't have meant anything to me. It would just be like just another victory or just another achievement, but it came to me naturally and suddenly, and I think that's what has occupied my heart right now, and that is what makes me proud. And that if y'all have checked my LinkedIn profile, they have given me a particular image also to put in my cover in my LinkedIn profile. So I think whenever I visit my profile or whenever I feel low, I just go randomly see my own profile and feel good about it. So it's my happy place to go to whenever I feel low in my life. So yeah, I think LinkedIn has given me a lot, and that is the thing I'm most proud of.
And you should be. It's a great validation to have, to continue to motivate you to do things that, you know, like you said, you didn't even think were possible. So yeah, congrats again. Let's switch gears a little bit and talk more specifically about you. And the way we do this is through a series of one-line life lessons. So please go ahead and share a few with us.
So I've realized this one thing that, you know, what sets you apart is just being ordinary. Because, you know, so many people are running behind doing extraordinary things that they forget being ordinary and being in their own state of mind. So I think whenever recruiters ask this question that what sets you apart, why should we hire you? You just say that you're ordinary and you're just having the common sense, which is not so common today, these days, you know. So I think doing ordinary things extraordinarily is something that I've learned through my years. And I can't emphasize much on this fact, because until you experience it, until something appeals to your senses, you really wouldn't believe in anything that comes your way. And even if you believe in it, it would be just for a temporary stage in your life. For something to be permanent, you need to understand it, because understanding builds trust. And this is the second life lesson that I've learned, you know, that, you know, even friendship demands certain sense of trust and certain sense of competence. And I've realized this as I networked in different conferences and at different events, that people wouldn't speak to you unless you have something in hand or something to offer. So I think that is the third lesson for me, that friendship also requires a certain sense of competence. Without that, you really can't speak to a person. So it's important to look into yourself. And that's the fourth lesson that I've learned from Buddha, that, you know, you are your own light. Just look into yourself and you will find solutions on your own way. You don't have to look here, there, or seek advice or waste time in waiting for others to help you. Just meditate, just keep your mind calm for a while, and you just know what is to be done next, you know. And I can't really explain it in words, because it really needs to be felt. And unless it's felt, it's never experienced. Life is all about experiences. And that is my other lesson, that, you know, just experience everything at first hand. Everybody can tell you stories, people can give TEDx talks, you can listen to it, and you can maybe memorize it or remember it also. But unless you do it yourself, unless you give that TEDx talk on the particular stage, you won't really know how that speaker feels or what's the intensity of the words that is speaking. So, you know, take a shot at everything in your life. And that is also another lesson. You know, never miss out on anything. It's good to take risks sometimes, but know your risk appetite, you know. Whenever you consume alcohol, people say that know your limits and then only do whatever you're doing. You know, if you know that there's no harm in doing it, just go ahead and do it. So I think know your risk appetite and then go forward and take risks in your life, because that's how you... you know, open your unexplored areas and charter into that territory. So I think these are some of the great life lessons that I've learned from different people in my life, from different experiences that I've had, and from some observations that I keep on making in my day-to-day life.
Radhika, I must commend you on all of the wisdom that you've already achieved at this age, and I can see that this has already set you on a path of success, and I can see exponential growth from here on. And we would love to continue this conversation and bring you back on and see what other accomplishments you have achieved. And thank you once again for taking the time to be with us and sharing your thoughts and one-line life lessons with our audience. We really appreciate it.
No, I genuinely enjoyed talking about all of these things, you know, because such kind of interviews are a mind opener for you. It's just like a teacher who would not really teach you what needs to be done, but would just open up your mind and tell you that, you know, these are the things that you need to think about. So I think this kind of an activity is a very good exercise for the mind also, to just travel back in time, experience those moments that you had in your mind, and then just talk about it in the form of words. So I think it was a great time to be here, although for a very brief period of time, but I'm sure it's never too late to do something.
Yes.
We will definitely catch up again and speak more about different life lessons, and I'd also like to hear your life lessons maybe at some point in time, that what have you learned, because it's always good to learn from different people around you, and that's how you grow. You never are inborn, you know, you don't ever have innate knowledge of anything, you just learn it from everyone around you. So yeah, thanks a lot for having me today.
Pleasure is all ours, Radhika, and thank you once again.